Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, we are going to see how to interface this BME680 sensor with ESP8266 module. By the end of this video, you will be able to measure temperature, humidity, pressure and gas levels. By the way, this video is sponsored by PCBWAY.com, but more on this later in the episode. So, what are we waiting for? Let's dive into the episode. For this project, you will need an ESP8266 module, a breadboard, some jumper wires, and let me introduce to you our star of the show, the BME680 sensor. This little device is like an environmental Swiss Army knife. It measures temperature, helping you gauge the warmth around you. It senses pressure, which is handy for predicting weather or estimating altitude. It keeps tabs on humidity, an essential metric for both comfort and health. And it even measures gas resistance, giving you insights into air quality, including CO2 levels. Understanding these measurements is the key for creating a safer and more comfortable environment. Curious about the nitty-gritty details of the sensor? You can always check out on-screen specs. If you are hungry for more information, feel free to pause the video. Moving to our wiring setup, we have a diagram that shows how to connect this BME680 to ESP8266 module. I've already set it up, but if you are following along, make sure those jumper wires are in the right places. Now, let's delve into the software side of things. Here is the code that we are going to upload to ESP8266 to measure temperature, humidity, pressure, and gas levels. At the beginning of our code, we include several libraries. These libraries provide the essential functions and tools needed for our project. For instance, the wire and SPI libraries help us to communicate with the BME680 sensor. And Adafruit sensor and Adafruit BME680 are libraries specific to our sensor. The wire and SPI libraries will be included with the ESP8266 add-on in Arduino IDE. The Adafruit sensor and BME680 we need to install from the library section. I have already installed Adafruit sensor library for a previous project, so I am not gonna install it again. To install a new library, go to the library section from the top left corner as shown here. Copy the library you would like to install and paste it in the library search bar. Then click on install. If it is suggesting other dependencies, click on install all or select whatever is needed. It will take some time to install the libraries. Wait patiently till the libraries get installed. Here we set a constant for sea level pressure in hectopascals. This constant is used to calculate approximate altitude based on the pressure readings. We create an instance of the Adafruit BME680 class and name it BME. This instance represents our BME680 sensor and use it to interact with it. The setup function. This is where we initialize the code. We establish communication with the computer through a serial monitor. And also, we will check to ensure the sensor is connected correctly. If the sensor is not found, the problem stops. In this part of the code, we configure various parameters of the BME680 sensor. We set oversampling for temperature, humidity, pressure, and we specify the filter size. Additionally, we set the gas heater parameters. These configurations ensure that our sensor provides accurate and stable readings. We introduce a delay of 20 seconds to allow the sensor to stabilize. This is important because the sensor initial readings may not be accurate until it reaches stable state. We start taking readings from sensor and calculate the baseline resistance, which is R0 of the gas sensor. This value is essential for estimating CO2 levels and must be measured in a fresh air environment. We define a function called estimated CO2 that calculates the estimated CO2 level in the parts per million or ppm based on the measured gas resistance and R0. In the loop, we continuously read data from BME680 sensor. We display various environmental parameters including temperature, pressure, humidity, gas, estimated CO2 levels and approximate altitude on the serial monitor. We then introduce a 2-second delay before repeating the process. Okay, that's the simple explanation of the code. Now let's prepare the Arduino IDE for ESP8266. Go to Tools and select ESP8266 module. In my case, it is NodeMCU 1.0 ESP12A module. Then connect your ESP8266 to the right port on your computer. Come back to Arduino IDE and select the port. In my case, it is COM7. You will be finding in the same way COM3, COM5 or COM4 like that. With everything set up, it's time to upload the code. Just hit the upload button and wait till you see done uploading. Okay, till the time this code gets uploaded to the ESP8266, let's talk about today's sponsor, PCBWAY.com. PCBWAY.com is an online PCB manufacturing enterprise that offers high quality PCBs for just $5. They provide all the services you need to create hardware for your IoT or embedded devices, including PCB prototyping, PCB assembly, manufacturing of FPC or rigid flex PCBs, and offering CNC and 3D printing services. If you have similar requirements, be sure to visit their website for more details using the link mentioned in the description below. Once you see done uploading, your device is ready to go. Are you eager to see the data? Okay, click on the magnifying glass icon to open the serial monitor. You may have to wait 20 seconds as we have introduced delay to allow the sensor to stabilize. Yeah, there. You will get real-time data of temperature, pressure, humidity, gas resistance and estimated CO2 levels. Be patient for the first 15 minutes cause the readings might not be stable or inaccurate as the sensor will take some time to settle and provide a stable readings for us. To sum it up, I hope this tutorial has added a touch of environmental intelligence to your tech toolkit. With the BME680 and ESP8266, you are all set to embark on the exciting sensor projects. Until our next tech adventure, take care and happy experimenting. Bye-bye.